Hey everyone, this is Jenny Pham from the Grafana Tempo team. Today we're going to talk about span events and how to query for them using TraceQL. What are span events? As the name goes, span events are part of a span. Take a look at this generic span that I borrowed from OTEL. As we can see here, events is a field inside the span schema. Also note that in the event schema there are three fields: name, timestamp, and attributes. But why should we use span events? Can't we just add more spans or more span attributes? Well, unlike span attributes, span events have timestamps. And span events are much more lightweight than spans. This means you can add more span events without worrying about bloating the size of your trace. So when should we use span events? While there are many creative ways to use span events, here are some common ones. You can track your errors by recording an exception event. Take a look at this trace. While you can always log your errors, recording an exception event means it is part of a trace, allowing you to track the error along the path of the request. While you can monitor performance with span as well, remember that events are much more lightweight and can also be useful to monitor interactions with external services. In this trace, we have two events to track a database query, and it looks like it only took around 60 nanoseconds. But we can use span events to also track connection type to monitor network latency or read logs to determine whether there's a locking issue in our path. OTEL says that we can think of events as structured logs, and the advantage events have over traditional logging is trace sampling, which has more capabilities. Let's say that you have a bug in your very complex algorithm. You notice that it only happened in the first path going from service A to B, then to C and D. If you were to put log lines in service C and D, you would see logs not only for the path that service A takes, you will also see logs for the path that service X takes as well, because service C and D are shared by the two paths. Imagine there are tens of other paths that share service C and D. You'll end up logging things that you're not actually interested in and unnecessarily increasing your logging usage. Not only that, but the extra logging without context might make it even harder for you to track your bug. What if instead of traditional logs, we use span events? We can use head sampling to sample only the path that service A takes. By doing that, we can control where and how much data we want to capture. Okay, we're on the Explore page. If you're already familiar with the TraceQL language, you might have already seen the two scopes that we have, which is span and resource. Right, for example, resource.serviceName. In the latest version of TraceQL, we have now also introduced the event scope. Following the OTEL schema for events, there are two intrinsics for events, which is timestamp and name. To search by event name, use the syntax event colon name. The colon here is for us to specify that this is an intrinsic, the intrinsic name and not an attribute. So the most common events that we have seen so far are exception events. And exception events, by definition, should have the name set to exception. So here we are, going to search for event name is equal to exception. Please ignore the red squiggly line here. We have not yet updated the UI to support the event scope, but trust me, it is already working. So let's go. Wow. So we can see that this synthetic data has a lot of events that have the name exception. Let's look at a few of them. Okay, let's look at this one. Remember, by clicking on the trace, the span ID here, we can jump straight to the span with the event. And here we can see there is one event with the name exception, and we can see the exception message and the stack trace printed up right here for us. Let's look at another example. Let's choose this one. Another exception, another error. right? So here again, we can see that there is an event here with name as exception. Exception type number 8. And again, we can see the stack trace of how this error came to be. And something that engineers tend to keep track of is response type, right? So, and I don't know exactly what the entire name of this event is, but it should probably have something with response in them. So we are simply going to do a partial match for response. And of course we got a match. Okay, we go response end. It looks like in this trace, we are fetching a document. And following this, we can see that there is a timestamp for when we start the fetch. Oh, and here is the response start and the response end time. As you can see here, we have a connection start time and a connection end time, which we can use to monitor latency between services. And here we have the response start time and the response end time, which we can use to monitor the performance of whatever operation is in here. Okay, now let's move on to event attributes. Let's say that searching for event name equal to exception gives us way too many results. Let's say you already looked at the log lines and it tells you exactly what the error is. We can simply search for the error using event. And if we follow the exception event schema, the exception message is where the error should be reported. So let's see, what is a common exception error that we could have? Let's say something exhausted, maybe? Okay, so as we can see here, we have two events and one of them matches what we are searching for, which is exception message resource, or we search for exhausted and it matched partially with this event. So it seems like this service needs someone to scale it up because we've already maxed out all the resources on the service. Okay, now that we know how to query for events, how can we make this information even more useful? As you may or may not know, we have an experimental metrics query that we can run. So let's say we are looking for all of the errors that is happening right now. Okay, so why don't we search for all of the exception events and see what exactly the errors are. So we are going to search for, first we're going to filter it down by name exception to find only the events that are erroring, the exception events only. Now we're going to pass this in the new rate by experimental feature, where we are going to rate by the event exception message. Like, now we should see the rate of spans with at least one exception event in the span. And we're going to drill it down even further by having a rate by function against event exception message. And voila. Right, and now we can see that in the last hour, we've had quite a few connection refuse error messages in our spans. How cool is that? So as you can see, querying for span events using TraceQL is now available for our Grafana Cloud Traces users. But for our Tempo OSS users, worry not, as it will be included in the next release. Thank you so much for listening to me talk about spend events. I hope you find the demo useful, and I will catch you next time. Take care, everyone, and go Tempo.